to our teeth, we usually think two things. One, we should take care of them by brushing regularly, and two, how terrifying it would be if pigeons had them. But of all the Gooches and Grundles that make up our dirty bodies, few play a more central role in our lives than teeth. We're even conditioned to base much of our self-esteem on them.
The first thing people notice is our smile.
Maybe you don't put a nice smile on your checklist for popularity, but it belongs there.
This is an all-American boy. The girls are wild about him until he smiles.
Sure, those chiclets are a problem, but as a woman, I have to say, he'll do okay with us because he is tall as f***. Sorry, short kings. But as important as our teeth are, they're barely an afterthought in America's never-ending healthcare disaster. While more than 27 million Americans lack general health insurance, almost three times as many have no dental coverage at all. Even basic adult Medicare recipients are out of luck because it has limited coverage of dental, hearing, and vision. Hence its slogan, who needs a working head? We often treat going to the dentist as a luxury, which is crazy because dental care is health care. Gum disease is associated with gastrointestinal problems, increased risk of cancer, cardiovascular disease, and the medical diagnosis, stank mouth. In addition to all the Americans who lack dental insurance, there are also those who have coverage but can't get treatment. Medicaid patients often have a hard time because some states don't cover dental care, while two-thirds of dentists won't even accept the program's low reimbursement rates, which is terrible because everyone, regardless of their ability to pay, deserves to get buzzed on that awesome gas at least once.
Is this real life?
But David got hooked. Now he meals nitrous oxide for a cartel. Making matters worse, 51 million Americans live in dental deserts, low-income areas that dentists avoid in favor of wealthier neighborhoods where people have insurance. In their defense, the average dental school grad has to pay off $300,000 in debt, plus the costs of office space, staff, and equipment. I mean, imagine owing all that money and still not being a real doctor. The lack of access to dentists is a big problem for Americans. Obviously, dental care is not something you should DIY, as evidenced by this video. Teeth. That's how a serial killer prepares for the hunt.